all eyes on our learning targets for today. Grace, can you please read to us so that I can?
So that I can make observations of math strategies helpful in solving division problems.
My goal for today's lesson was for the students to be able to recognize and being able to observe what is a division problem. So when would you use it? And I didn't want to label any quotients, dividends, or divisors without them recognizing what those numbers mean in context of an actual math problem.
I think these two are connected because this one is the answer and that one and that one is dividing, but it's multiplying, and this number's the answer, and this one is this. So I think we have to find, like, if the answer was like what Heath said, then the question mark here might be the same answer.
We have our carousel protocol today, and each station is set up with a thinking question. And those are different strategies that you may find helpful. So I want you to just to make some observations, talk with your group partners, and look, observe, how does it connect?
When delivering this lesson, I chose the carousel protocol because it's away from their desk, and the whole focus in a carousel is to talk, to write down responses, your thoughts, to think and capture. Because when they're in their desk and they have any question that requires an answer, they're not thinking at all about the math concepts. They just want the right answer. So taking them out of that context and putting them through a carousel opens up that it's safe now. I don't need the answer. It's okay to explore.
You'll know that you have it when you can explain how to divide decimals to the hundredths place. So that's a big goal for today. And we'll accomplish that by talking with each other and really looking at those stations.
So as we moved into the next topic, which would be division, I wanted them to really understand how place value plays in the role for the decimals up to the hundredths.
Some of us were confused since it says 36 tenths. I think we have to find what goes here, like hundredths, ones, thousandths, tenths, like that.
And I think this one we have to find like one of those to try and see what it equals.
So let's think about these three, one, two, and three, and just think about how they connect to each other. How are they connecting to other math concepts that you already have learned that we've been talking about? So let's take a look right here at some of our symbols.
There we've been learning how to divide. So it's kind of like when we divided. So like if we divide these two numbers and we get the answer, it's kind of what we did before.
So then why do I have number two right next to it? 3/10 times the question mark equals 3 6/10. How are they connected? Just focus on 1 and 2 and try to discover what their connection is. And then if you could write your response down.
I selected some questions that focused in on connecting place value. And then I also selected some questions that led to a good way to make a picture. And also connecting in, if I don't know how to do division, maybe I could do repeated subtraction. Maybe I could change it and make it into a multiplication problem. I wanted them to understand that there was no one way to tackle a division problem. So I was trying to select 4 different strategies that they could use.
If it's 27 tenths and she marked it off with 5 to 9 equal sections, wouldn't you draw a couple sections and just do separate them all by nine
equal sections, so it has to be an equal number in each 9 sections.
Yeah, why don't you just do that? Why don't you just draw like 9 sections or something, and then put like a mark each time, and then count them, and then put under it.
Done.
Okay, so put 2.7.
You're putting
2.7.
And then hey. Me,
would it be 9 circles?
And myself occurred to me my idea.
Okay, we concur to yours too. So we agree to yours too, but
which one should I use?
We think we should put it in 9 sections because it's
it's a
It's a 2.7 kilometer race.
She uses flags to mark it in 9 equal sections. And how far should she, how far apart should she space the flags to mark off? So you draw like 9 circles and then just mark them and then count them and then you just write the number down and that's your answer.
Yeah. So can you draw 9 circles?
That's a real important part of the rigor because now instead of giving up, I need them to keep going. Throw away everything that they've done, start from scratch again. So let's draw a new picture. That one didn't work. So within that carousel, there's opportunity to start over. There's opportunity to keep going. And one person gets stuck and they feel like giving up, then their partner's there to catch them.
It's equal. So it's when it would be 3. So just do 3 ticks in each one. Because it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
It's kind of like divided by 9.
Yes.
Yes.
That's what I've been trying to say.
So
I knew you had to multiply and divide it by something. Here? So you divide by 9.
No, divide by 3, because then it would be
by
3
9.
Right there.
No, because there's a 9.
I built rigor into my lesson through the carousel with the deep understanding, with the questioning. So each pose thinking question was to really get them starting to communicate with each other. They have to decide on their own how they're going to tackle that problem. I did notice in one of the groups that they figured it out. They thought they were successful and then went back and looked. Well, that didn't make sense.
Just divide by 9.
Oh, okay. It's a simple question, just like 20. So it'll be 27 divided by 9, and then you divide it and get 3. And then you'd write, and then the question is, how far apart should she space the flags to mark sections? Well, it'd be 9 kilometers.
The struggling that the students are going through relates to deep understanding because they're having to persevere and work through a problem. So it's very difficult for them at first. They'll read it and they'll think, I don't know how to do it. But once they start talking with each other, one person might pull in some place value that we've talked about, some other math concept that we've talked about, and they'll play off one another.
Do 27 divided by 9, and that equals 3. So then you write 3 kilometers.
Divided as
3. Well, she put in right here.
Okay, that's fine.
So equals 3.
In the beginning where it's, I don't know how to do it, all of a sudden rolls into, oh, maybe we could use this. And so they start bouncing ideas back and forth with each other. They might not always come to a conclusion at the end, but at least they've been thinking through and how these strategies might be a part of this.
So here are your next set of directions. Now you have all the other groups having added to your thoughts. So I would like for you now to try to check and read, figure out what the other teams were thinking. I'm going to give you 2 minutes to capture the other team's thinking.
Yeah, we disagree with 3 km.
Orange because it cannot be, sorry, you read.
Orange because it cannot, can't be 3 km because there is only 2.7 kilometers.
We're using kilometers, that's bigger than meters, so why don't we just say that there's 3 meters between each space?
It's kilometers, not meters, so it would be like 3 whole kilometers, so it would be 3 meters, because that's small.
But it's also asking you how far apart should she space the flags to mark off the sections.
Yeah, that was our answer. It would be 3 kilometers and like 3 meters apart.
But there's only 2 and 7 of the race.
7 of the race.
Walking around the carousel, I'll have a pretty general idea of who's going in the right direction and who's not. Even though I'm not there, I can still look at their writing and I know what color they are. So I know where their thinking process is. For one instance, one group started right in with an algorithm. I was a little surprised to even see that because it's not anything that we have taught. So I know that they're pulling in a lot more of their background knowledge. And I also know that I have to shift their thinking a lot more to get away from the algorithms right now. That's not our focus. More pictures, more talking, more deep understanding.